3 and 4, I stand before this door and before you to bring to you some words that were handed down to the children of Israel on the Mount of Sinai. There were guidelines as to how we should live for God. And just as they were good in those days, they are as good today. So that you are called upon to listen and listen attentively. Because at one point in time, these same words will come to judge you. All of us. So, open your ears. Hearken unto the word of the Lord. And it shall bless your heart. As found in the book of Exodus chapter 20. And God spake all his words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of body. Thou shalt have no other God before me.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Neither shall you take unto you but the gold. And all the of all thou shalt make unto me, and shall sacrifice thereof, thy burnt offering, and thy peace offering, thy sheep and thy ox. In all places where I record my name, I will come unto thee, and I will bless thee. And if thou wilt today be an altar of stone, thou shalt not fear this altar of stone. For if thou wilt lift up thy tools upon it, thou hast erased it. Neither shalt thou go up thy steps unto mine altar.
Name of the Lord, for there are set thrones of judgment
throughout the house of David,
pray for the peace and love thee. They shall prosper and love thee, feed me in thy wall and prosper with thee in the palaces. For my virgin and companion, I will see thy goal.
Happy Bangsa.
Bring them across. It's just a big idea.
Can I hold
the chair
so that
she can
sacrifice for us?
Wait. All right.
Push up.
Come up to Abraham Bosom, come up to Abraham Bosom, come up to Abraham's Bosom, come up to Abraham's Bosom, come up to Abraham's
Bosom,
come up to Abraham's Bosom, come up to Abraham's Bosom, with all them sheep.
Number three.
We have
things to do. We are going to move expeditiously, that means quickly. Praise the Lord. First of all, you know, we have certain administrative duties to perform. And that is the reading of the notices, taking of the offerings, and then we may or may not ask for a testimony or two. Prayer time has already completed. Praise the name of the Lord. So we are moving on. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I want to sing your chorus. Declare the name of Jesus when you child of sorrow and of woe. That the doors are kept open. Amen?
Amen.
What you give to the Lord, yes, give it in Jesus' name. What you give to the Lord, yes, give it in Jesus' name. What you give to the Lord, yes, give it in Jesus' name. And I hear you before we take the notices, I would want to thank, and I am thanking all the brethren from every other gathering for gathering with us today. We thank you for your presence, and we do hope and trust that we will continue with this bond of fellowship, one with the other. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord loves you, and we love you too. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Notice it.
To God be the glory. Great things he has done. So loved he the world that he gave us his son, who healed in his life an atonement for sin, and he opened the life gate that all may go in.
Praise God.
Greetings to my bishop, to the mothers, to all mothers, all co-workers in the vineyard. A pleasant good evening. It is so wonderful to see you in the house of the Lord today. And today is a day that the Lord has made. We must rejoice and be glad in it. Our announcement we have for today, we have had a letter been standing for quite a while, coming from St. Peter's Secret Hat in Montreal. And they're asking us to attend the First Spiritual Baptist Appreciation Thanksgiving. And this will be on the 28th. This will be on the 28th of October 2017 at 6 p.m. Now if anyone who would like to go, maybe you can see Pastor Levison and Mother King, so you guys can make arrangement to visit St. Peter's Secret Heart in Montreal. I have a very important announcement to make, and our announcement, what we're making, I'm making here today, is that we have had a meeting on September the 15th, and board members was elected. And we have Brother Rob as the president. We have the vice president as Mother Small. We have the treasurer as Sister Oke. An assistant treasurer as Mother Cora. We have the secretary as Mother Evangelist. An assistant secretary as Sister Felicia. And we have the chairperson as Pastor Nevison. With this decision that we have made, the church is moving forward. As we take step by step, we will inform you of what is happening. We had asked for a special donation a few weeks ago in the moving on of forward of the church, and we have received $182, and we are still asking for special funds. So anyone who wants to help the church move forward, I am asking you today to please grant us a special donation so we can move forward with the situation. I had also announced, because we have lots of young people in our congregation, and I have asked our members to just bring one perishable food item that we can place it in a basket and we can divide it into three and give to someone in our congregation. And we have to do it in our home first before we can go out and do it outside. So,
when you said that you'll bring a perishable thing for somebody in the congregation, that would make the church move on. How could that be?
That would make the church move on.
Yes,
it will, because you know what? We are helping. Someone is in need. This is what the church is all about. The church is all about charity. And we may come into the church and we're well fed, we're well dressed, but there's somebody sitting in a corner that may need a can of milk, that may have a child, who does not have a snack for school. And when I ask for perishable items, I am a non-perishable item, I'm asking for maybe a box drink, maybe a can of milk, maybe a box of cookie, maybe some bear paws, maybe some applesauce. That's what I'm asking for. And it's to hand up for people that are in need in the congregation. Organization, and that's what we have to do. We need to do that. As Christian people, that is what we are all about.
Amen.
That is what we need to do. That's what we need to do. So
I am asking,
this is a cry that is going out. Not for me and not for you, but to help your fellow brethren. That is why we are here today, congregate like this. Because we are sharpening iron with iron to help each other, regardless of what the situation is. And we can do it. Yes. By the help of God,
Hallelujah.
Can
do it.
Amen. So in the name of Jesus. So in the name of Jesus.
Claim it. Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Claim it. We claim it.
The living God. We are claiming it. We are claiming it. We are claiming it.
Come on, man.
We are claiming this.
Yeah, excuse me.
So,
excuse me, please. If I can be a palace of God, say,
amen.
That's right.
That's right.
This is the place to stop God. If you can't be a palace of God, say,
yes.
I'm not going to stand for the stupidity and the disrespect in the house of God. This is not the place for this.
Yeah. You know, read, man. That's the Lord.
Yeah, but it's true.
If
you're not talking, leave it at all.
Yes, man.
If you have something to say, ask for an excuse.
Yes, sir.
I don't let you see stupidity in the house of God. I just get mad.
Yes, Mother. Yes, Pastor Action.
No, from the time you said that you're talking not going on.
Yes, Pastor Action.
Right.
It is something good. Because if we look in a cupboard, we have things that we don't really need or do not use. Or if we can just pick one up and bring it in. There will be a basket inside. You just bring it and put it in. If you're not passing by, just give it to someone. We'll put it in the basket and we'll get to go.